My name's Eeples Vox, and today I will be discussing the Elgato Sound Capture side of the Elgato Game Capture HD software. I will have other tutorials on Elgato's capture cards and a plethora of other technology topics on my channel, so be sure to subscribe if you find this video helpful, and check the YouTube card icon above or the description below with a playlist for my other Elgato gaming related videos. In the previous tutorial, I showed you how you can use the powerful stream command to create a fantastic live stream or recording setup. Part of that also involves mixing sound from multiple sources, and Elgato offers their new Sound Capture app to help with that. Elgato Sound Capture is a powerful tool to give you complete control over your audio output and mixing for your live stream and recording sessions. This gives you complete control over what's heard on stream and how your final export sounds, based on settings we covered in the previous video. For example, you can use this to loop in your own music to play in the background of a live stream. This is common and a fun expectation of some viewers. Using the export options, you can then exclude the music from your final export for YouTube without having to worry about the music causing you pesky copyright problems. Alternatively, you could use it to loop in team chat from voice over IP programs such as Skype, TeamSpeak, Discord, or Ventrilo. Or you can use it to send all of your audio out to your headphones and a second PC for dual PC streaming and recording setups. There's a lot you could do with this. To work with the Elgato Sound Capture app, make sure your Game Capture HD software is updated and that you're on the Capture tab. Look below the Live Commentary section and you'll see a section for Elgato Sound Capture. You're presented with volume meters, similar to game audio and live commentary, volume adjustment, a preview loopback toggle, and a capture checkbox, along with the settings cog. Click on the settings gear icon and it will open up the Sound Capture app. This will take a minute and will possibly change your speaker output configuration, but fear not, this will allow you to set up things quite nicely. This tool gives you a few basic configurations that you might want to use, picking up team chat, streaming music, PC gaming, and an advanced tab to customize things just how you want. Clicking on the team chat tab gives you some basic options to control which mic you want your chat buddies to hear, which could be different from your stream mic, and which audio output, headphones, speakers, etc., that you want to hear the chat out of, along with a volume meter. It's worth noting that many voice over IP programs like Skype and Discord do not automatically change which mic and output device it uses, so you'll want to go into those program settings and make sure that they match. When you select this, Elgato includes a link for setup instructions for Skype specifically, and the similar steps should be followed for Discord as well. Clicking on the Music tab gives you the option to choose which output your music plays to. You can set this to a specific headphone or speaker that you wish to hear from, or to an output that you don't actually have hooked up. This way you don't have to hear the music, but your viewers can. The PC Gaming tab is a little more complicated. This is used when you're using a capture card for your PC gameplay, either on the same PC that you're gaming on or on a secondary streaming and recording rig. For a single PC setup, this will set your gameplay sound to play via the HDMI output to be captured via your Elgato device, but still play it back to your speakers or headphones so that you can actually hear it. For a dual PC setup, this does the same thing, but you'd have it run the audio output to a mixer or soundboard, or simply hook up your headphones to the streaming and capturing rig instead of the gaming PC. Or you could also run the Sound Capture app on your gaming rig, tell it to send the gameplay sound to your headphones and HDMI output, and the streaming rig will still get it. However, you want to set it up. It will work out great. Lastly, we have the Advanced tab. This one is pretty cool. You can make it set your PC's default audio devices for playback and communication as Sound Capture's virtual device. Select an audio input to send to voice chats or the live stream, and then select whichever output device, or multiple output devices, that you want your audio to go to. Then you could set it up to go out via HDMI to the capture card and headphones or speakers or anything, really. If you're setting up a sound capture configuration, you're going to want to triple check two things. One, that your capture from sound capture checkbox is checked in the main Elgato window. And two, in the main software settings, you want to make sure that track exporting and mixing options are set up how you want for your final video exports. I covered the details of this in a different tutorial, which will be linked in the YouTube card icon and the video description. But that's it. With this and the stream command, I'd argue that the Game Capture HD software from Elgato is potentially the most powerful streaming and recording software available for consumers, provided that you're using one of their cards. It even beats out some of the expensive pro-level options that I've used. I hope this video has been helpful for you. If it has, do a barrel roll into that like button. Get subscribed for more awesome tech videos, and check out the description below. There, I have a link to the playlist with all of my Elgato gaming tutorials and reviews. Check them out. I also have product links to each Elgato cards if you're looking to buy one for yourself. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.